Hello dear viewers, in this video we will learn about the properties of covalent compound. As covalent compounds are formed by mutual sharing of the electrons, and these covalent compounds are of two types, simple molecular substances and gained covalent structure. They have low melting and boiling point as compared to ionic compounds, as the covalent bonds are weaker than ionic bonds. Let us take an example of chlorine molecule. Although the covalent bond in one chlorine molecule is stronger, and we have to supply a large amount of energy to break this covalent bond. But in case of the molecular forces, different chlorine molecules are joined together by weak van der Waal forces of attraction. This molecular forces are so weak that its boiling point is only minus 34 degrees Celsius. As different chlorine molecules are joined together by weak van der Waal force of attraction, different molecules are joined together by molecular forces of attraction. These molecular forces are depends upon the size of the molecules. Larger the size of the molecule, stronger is the force of attraction. Let us take the example of halogen molecules. Different halogens have different size. Therefore, their boiling points are different. In case of bromine, it has 59 degrees Celsius and iodine has 184 degrees Celsius boiling point. As the size of iodine is much larger than chlorine, therefore, the molecular forces of attraction between iodine molecule are so stronger, so that it has high melting and boiling point. Next property is conductivity. All the covalent molecule, they are bad conductor of electricity, or they don't conduct electricity even in their molten state, as they don't have free ion or free electron to move. There are a large number of covalent molecules which are formed by non-metals, just like diamond, graphite and silicon dioxide. They have regular geometry, but they don't conduct electricity. These all molecules are joined together by covalent bond. They all have strong melting and boiling point as compared to simple covalent structure, but they don't conduct electricity. Although graphite is an exceptional case, it conducts electricity as it has one free electron. That free electron is responsible for conduction of electricity. In silicon dioxide, the ratio of its constituent particles is 1:2. Here, one silicon atom is combined with two oxygen atoms to form three-dimensional structure, due to which there is strong force of attraction and it has high melting and boiling point. In case of the simple molecular substances, there is weak intermolecular forces of attraction, therefore they have less melting and boiling point as compared to the gained covalent structure or polymers. Thank you.